everybody doing tonight? I hope everybody's having a good night. I've been working all goddamn day. How is everyone doing? You say aerodrome. Gregory just got home, ready to learn. What are you ready to learn today? You ready to learn today? I hope you're ready to learn today, because that's what the fuck we're here for. We ready to fucking learn. Sorry, that was a little aggressive. I don't mean to be that aggressive. from Tampa, Florida, how is it going? So today we're going to be doing some NeoFly. For those of you who don't know what NeoFly is, NeoFly gives a, what's the best way to put it? Gives a campaign to Microsoft Flight Sim. What's up, Steve, over on Twitch? I DM'd you, CheesePilot, can you reply? Sam, let me take a look. We're going to read it out loud. I hope it's not embarrassing. Okay, well, if it's embarrassing, we're not going to read it out loud. I got a couple different requests. All right, shoot. You know? Can you do a brief about the lesson? So today's lesson, we're mainly just going to focus on IFR travel. So we're going to be flying from point A to point B. We're going to try and get a craft clearance, right? What that clearance is, you know, I'm going to Chicago. I filed a flight plan via VATSIM, and it does seem like there's controllers on. Let me see. Let me look at VATSPY real quick just to see it. So there is no controller on at Green Bay. So it looks like we're going to have to talk to Minneapolis Center to get our clearance. So this is kind of like taking off from an uncontrolled airport. What is a METAR? It's a meteorological weather report, right? So somebody has looked at the weather and reported it. Let's work on the 107. What do you mean the 107? Like the drone certificate? I don't know what you're talking about. Drone certificates are cool though. But so today's is really just going to be focusing on instrument. We're not going to be doing any kind of maneuvers, but this is going to behave kind of like we're getting a clearance from an uncontrolled field. That's what's going on. So we're departing from Green Bay, right? And we're going to Chicago. We've got a couple passengers. I also have right up here, I've got a little, I've got a stream deck that's got all my radio and stuff. I'll control your field. Oh, come on, Necromancer. Why you gotta be dirty like that? Why you gotta be dirty? Motivate me to clear the commercial pilot exams. What do you mean by motivate you? Fucking do it. Just fucking do it. I don't like, is that what you're asking for? Here, wait. I think, no, that doesn't work on this screen. Just do it, right? Go get Glime, go get Shepherd Air, go get, you know, whatever it takes, right? Starting med second phase of my flight training. I'm assuming you say my second phase of flight training. Can you give me some advice? What do you mean by second phase? Like what's the instrument, commercial, stage, or, you know, second block of private pilot? Like every school has got their own kind of like specific thing going on. So saying second phase isn't really like, doesn't give me enough information, but you're probably going to kick ass at it. I will control your, god damn it, Steve. What this, I'm gonna stop streaming to Twitch just because y'all are some dirty motherfuckers over there. Twitch is some dirty, like y'all some dirty motherfuckers. All right. Now private pilot again, second phase. Like I'm not sure what second phase refers to. What do you think about the impossible turn? No one talks about it anymore. And too much of new pilots, do a soft takeoff every time in time building and in hot weather. I don't know. Like, I mean, don't do the impossible turn. It's called impossible for a reason. Stage two is solo prep. Is it solo prep or actual solo? Because I mean, if it's solo, just go do your solo flights, you know? Yeah, just go do your solo flights. Like, I mean, it's time building effectively, right? It's fun. Look at your weather. Make sure you talk to your instructor about weather, right? Try to ask for their advice. But I mean, by the time you get to solo, you should be trying to make these decisions on your own. So don't ever go to your instructor. If you're in your solo phase of flight training, don't ever go to your instructor and say, hey, this weather exists. Should I go fly? That's for you to decide, right? If you are concerned, go to your instructor and say, hey, this is the weather. These are the decisions I made based on it. And based on your experience, would you confirm or would you concur with these decisions? Right? You see the difference? If you just go and say,
hey, but instructor, I saw the BTAR seemed scary. Should I go fly? I don't know. I'm so scared.
See, that's not what you're looking for, right? We want you to build the experience. We want you to build the decision making. So what we want you to do is go, hey, instructor, this is the weather I found. This is the things that I am reading from this weather. Or this is the airplane. These are the items that might be broken on it. These are the decisions I've made based on the things I have seen. I'm going to go fly. I'm not going to go fly. Do you concur? That is what solo is for. It's for you to build your own decision-making model. It's for you to build your own thought process and see if your instructor concurs. Not go, hey, instructor, I'm a dumb. I don't know what I'm doing. All right. I'm not saying that y'all are dumb. I'm just saying that, like, it's up to you. It's up to you. Okay. So let's. You and your fancy flip phone. I know. It's so fancy. It's so fancy. I love this thing. But let's get into some Microsoft Flight Sim. All right, so here we are in Microsoft Flight Sim. Y'all should be able to see my my controls, right? Y'all should be able to see my controls all right here. So I've got, you know, the throttle, got the autopilot panel, I've got any kind of associated switches, I got flaps. Well, y'all can't see the flaps, actually. Let me back that up a smidge. God damn it, drill, get out of the way. There. There we go. All right. And then we've got the yoke over here. I don't know. Do y'all really want to be able to see the yoke a little bit better? Maybe. There we go. Can you brief about 45 degree turns? So 45 degree turns, I mean, we're going to be doing steep turns. You're going to be transitioning from a low, you know, you're going to be splitting your angle of bank, right? You're going to be, or not your angle of bank, you're going to be splitting your lift. So right here, straight and level flight, you've got all lift going up. As soon as you bank over, what you're going to end up doing is getting like kind of like a split lift vector where some of it's taking you sideways, some of it's taking you up. So you're going to need more lift. How do I get more lift? Pull back. When I pull back, I induce more what? Drag. How do I overcome drag? By applying more power. Whee! That's why you got to add more power on steep turns. X-plane is better. X-plane is an option. Microsoft Flight Sim's free. It's with Game Pass. I'm not going to pay for something that I already get for free. All right, so I'm gonna open up NeoFly. Y'all should be able to see NeoFly. No, y'all can't see NeoFly. Why is NeoFly not popping up? Boop-a-doo, NeoFly settings, because it's, there we go. All right, y'all are seeing NeoFly. So what NeoFly is it adds a campaign. It adds a campaign to Microsoft Flight Sim. If you are looking into it, make sure you tell them CheesePilot sent you so that hopefully they pay me. So here we are in the TBM 930, right? This is the plane that we're going to be flying, and we've got a mission to take one passenger, I'm assuming with some cargo, because it's one passenger at a weight of 537 pounds. I'm assuming we're not flying somebody from my 600 pound life, so I'm gonna guess that they've got some bags with them, and we're taking them all the way down to Chicago. What's up, Camden Shell? Yes, if you have Game Pass for Xbox, you get Microsoft Flight Sim for free. I prefer it on the PC because, well, let's just be honest, I can do mods, I can do all kinds of fancy stuff on the PC. All right, this honeycomb setup doesn't work on the PC. This Stream Deck thing that I got right here, or it does work on the PC, it doesn't work on, y'all know what the fuck I'm saying. All right. So, but we have also filed a flight plans. We are going to be on VATSIM. So let's get after it. There we go. So here we are, world map. we're going to be departing from here. Well, you know what? I'll just set it. Set departure. No, I don't want to be at the fuel box. Being at the fuel box makes it a pain in the ass to taxi away. All right, we're gonna start right here. What's up, Raven Amberfield? They never responded. I told them to shoot me an email about all the details, and they never sent me one. So I don't know. I don't know if I'm going on that trip. I don't know how much I'm allowed to talk about it, given that, like, no agreement. Well, you know what? Fuck it. No agreement ever came. Desktop pilot, the people who sent me those controls up there, they offered to fly me out to Manila, Philippines, to their factory, to, you know, check out their full motion sim. Thanks for that follow, M971. Thank you so much. Love it. I love it. So they invited me to come out to the Philippines to check out their full sim, and then they never sent me an email. So I don't know. I don't know if that's happening. Hopefully it's happening, but so far it doesn't seem too good. All right, let me just make sure. Missing 367 pounds. So what we need to do is, oh, NeoFly is still up. I forgot. I have to minimize it to get it to go away. All right. So weight and balance, I'm missing about 300 pounds. So we're going to go to our payload and we're going to increase our payload. Can you go over the four forces of flight enacted on an aircraft? Yes, you have lift, weight, drag, and thrust. All right. Lift, it's what takes you up. Generation of lift. The main principles are, you know, Bernoulli's principle and Newton's third law. Yes, there's the Coriander effect, and there's all kinds of other effects that go into account when thinking of the generation of lift. What's up? Oh, God damn it, Steve. I am sorry. But then we also have drag. There's two different types of drag. There's induced drag, and then there's parasitic drag. Induced drag is drag that's generated by the generation of, well, lift. And then you have parasitic drag. There's just parasitic drag. What is parasitic drag? Parasitic drag is like the form of an aircraft, right? Event list. There we go. But then we also have thrust. Thrust is generated from... Thanks for that follow, Shark Attack! Awesome. Awesome. All right, so we've got our fuel in. Nope, still missing 164 pounds. Let's go ahead and increase our weight just a little bit more. No audio for it? God damn it. One second. Already can't accept it. I don't have a commercial license. What do you mean already can't accept it that you don't have a commercial license over on YouTube? Overlays, open as HUD. There we go. It should work now. Hide. Awesome. What mission? I'm not sure what mission you're talking about, man. Sorry, I'm not getting the joke. How much will it cost to set up a simulator? So Honeycomb was about $400. The big old monitor was, I don't know, $200. The computer's $1,200. Stream Deck. I don't know. The Stream Deck's $100. No, $2,000. All right. So airplane's not on. Let's go ahead, power up the airplane, get our beacon on. We're going to leave our avionics off. Let's go ahead, crank that starter. And let's get our prop out of feather. And everything is spinning up. Engine started. And we will contact the tower, actually. Off-topic question. Do you think mock oral... do you do mock orals with anyone? I have CSE check coming up. Commercial single engine. And I mean, yeah, I do. So if you go to trainingwithcheese.com, you'll get all the details there. Trainingwithcheese.com is where all the details are about the mock check rides. Good questions, though. Good questions. So what we're going to do is we have VATSIM, all right? And we have VPilot. VPilot is how we talk to them. Let's connect Microsoft Flight Sim. We're going to connect it. All right, I'm connected to the voice server. Looks like we've got Minneapolis is going to be my closest one. So we're going to set 121.5. 121. 05. There. Did that go? Oh, yeah, it did. Awesome. Factors of left turning tendencies. You answer them. Yes, this is the TBM 930 again. Let me just make sure settings. Push to talk button. Yep, that's what we want. All right, and let's get just a smidgen of power in. There we go. And Minneapolis Center. This is Cheese 1 at Green Bay trying to pick up my clearance to Chicago. No? Nothing? Let me guess. They logged off. No, they're still there. What happened with the Dragon? Minneapolis Center. That's the ATIS. Well, let's try 133.4. Minneapolis Center. This is Cheese 1 at Green Bay trying to pick up my clearance to Chicago.
November 1, Hotel Tango.
Affirmative. November 1, Hotel Tango.
November 1, Hotel Tango. Will you do me a favor, just refile your flight plan, please? I'm not showing anything in the system.
Will do. November 1, Hotel Tango.
Delta 208, clear direct rock.
All right, so as y'all could tell, I must have fucked something up when filing my flight plan. okay, yeah, no, that's all squared away. Let's see. Can you go over what you are speaking? What do you mean? What am I speaking? So November 1, Hotel Tango, that's my clearance. Yes, I am on VATSIM. And I'm talking to Minneapolis.
3000A leaving the airspace to the west. Salt Lake Center is closed.
And I'm talking to Minneapolis Center right now, trying to pick up my clearance to Chicago, because I'm currently at Green Bay trying to fly to Chicago.
1824 leaving the airspace to the west. Denver Center is closed. Radar service is terminated. Change to advisory is approved.
Hey man, how you doing? In school, always recommend to do an approach into ITL. Do you think that's all right? Technum, I'm not sure what approach on IDDL E. I'm not sure what that is.
Service is terminated. Change to advisory is approved. Take care.
And Minneapolis Center. This is November 1 Hotel Tango again. Did you get that clearance?
Not a 108, absolutely. You have a go night. And November 1 Hotel Tango, negative. I'm still not showing anything in the system under the call sign of November 1 Hotel Tango. Delta 1280, contact Minneapolis approach 121.05. Take care.
All right. I guess he didn't like my clear. I put Cheese One as my call sign, and I guess he didn't like it.
6-3 Minneapolis Center. Hello. Climb and maintain flight level 350. Clear direct India. Romeo Kilo.
And Minneapolis Center, I had the wrong call sign in there. You got November 1 Hotel Tango now?
November 1 Hotel Tango. Okay, yeah, I got you now. You're clear from the Green Bay Airport to the O'Hare Airport. That's filed. Climb maintain 4,000. And departure is this frequency, Squawk 2623.
Squawk 2623 as filed. And departure this frequency, November 1 Hotel Tango.
November 1 Hotel Tango, read back correct. Advise that you to taxi runway 264, I think it's 24 for departure, the Green Bay altimeter 2999.
I appreciate it. I'll let you know when I'm ready. And what was that transponder code again?
The code for you is going to be 2623.
2623, appreciate it. November 1 Hotel Tango. What's up, Down Under Daddy? Thank you for that follow.
November 145 Alpha Juliet, contact Chicago.
All right,
Center,
so we got cleared as filed. Let me go take a look at my clearance again just to make sure I've got the right thing in. So we're going
to
be doing
Alpha Juliet, just to make sure I heard it right. 125.
Green Bay
5,
to Falls
7.
For the Maddie 7. So let's go ahead, go MFD, flight plan, add an origin. It's going to be KGRB. Enter. Then we're going to add a waypoint. Waypoint is going to be FAALZ. Enter. Why did my origin not go? KG.
Tango 57 sounds good. I got that in there for you.
Enter. There we go. KGRB to Falls. And let's go down. Let's add a destination of Chicago. KORD. Enter. There's our destination. Now let's select procedure. We're going to be doing the Maddie 7s. So let's go for the Maddie 7 arrival. Push down. There's
Air
the
Canada
Maddie 7 via
Center.
Falls. Let's just go for runway 4 left.
Center,
let's load it. Awesome. Awesome. All that is loaded. Now we need to. Yes, I am a real pilot. I am at Green Bay right now, but since we're doing VATSIM, Minneapolis is the closest. It's the closest controller right now.
All
right, they gave me an altitude to head up to. They told me to go up to 4,000.
The Des Moines altimeter 3014.
All right, 4,000 is the initial altitude. We got our transponder code. All right, I'm happy. Let's let them know we're ready to go. All right, well. Actually, what I'm going to do, let me make sure that I am all set up. Auto on that. Start a good ignition.
1625 Minneapolis Center. Climb and maintain flight level.
Then we're
going to
throw our nav light, our taxi light. All right. All that is good. Now let's go over to our MFD. Switch over to the right panel, and then we're going to go MFD, switch to the right panel, and we're going to go charts. Charts.
WestJet 270, clear direct Gulf, Romeo Bravo.
And here's our taxi diagram. So he said expect runway 24. Runway 24 is right there. Awesome. Is the process of becoming a 107 commercial pilot? Any study recommendations? What do you mean by study recommendations? It's pretty straightforward, isn't it? What are you flying as an airline pilot? So I am typed in the Airbus A320.
Whiskey, Minneapolis Center. Hello, climb and maintain flight level 310, and you're cleared direct Des Moines.
You found me on Carly? What's Carly? Oh, VATSPY. VATSPY.
The airspace to the south, Kansas City Center closed. Radar services terminated. Change to advisory is approved. Take care.
All right. Now let's let them know we're ready to go. Well, let me set flaps for takeoff, and then we'll be ready to go. Well, altimeter, 2999.
Delta 246, Minneapolis, are you back?
Well, is it? I guess since I'm so, I spent so much time as a pilot, reading the weather and the sectionals was just kind of common sense at that point. Take a ground school. Find a flight instructor.
36 Minneapolis Center, the Des Moines altimeter 3014.
Minneapolis Center, this is November 1 Hotel Tango, ready to taxi.
November 1 Hotel Tango, runway 24, taxi via Delta, advise ready for departure.
Runway 24, taxi via Delta, and I'll let you know when I'm ready to go. November 1 Hotel Tango.
Air Canada 1745, just to verify you're still climbing to flight level 360, correct?
Yeah, we've got load over climbing there.
All right.
Roger.
Delta 246, checking back.
Good shit, good shit. And clear right.
Minneapolis Center, Roger.
Thanks for that follow, Dymol Chris.
Climb and maintain flight level 330, clear direct hold.
Check our flight controls. All that works. All that works. And we already checked our... Oh, God, this thing taxis. This thing taxis real quick. Like, that nose wheel is super sensitive. All right, let's head back inside. Minneapolis Center, holding short runway, or November 1 Hotel Tango, holding short runway 24, ready to go.
Lufthansa 481, Minneapolis Center, hello, Ida. Number 1 Hotel Tango, wind 25010, flight runway heading, runway 24, clear for takeoff.
Runway heading, runway 24, clear for takeoff. November 1 Hotel Tango. All right. What we're going to do. We're going to taxi out onto the runway. As we're taxiing out onto the runway, we're going to set runway heading of 240.
208, descend via Nitzer 3, arrival runway 30 left, transition to Minneapolis, altimeter 3005.
And runway heading, power up. Airspeed alive. I didn't put my V-speeds up, but we'll be fine. It's just a TBM.
Get out of 2265, descend at pilot's discretion, maintain 17,000, the Des Moines.
Positive rate,
3014.
Gear up. Climbing out.
17,000 for United 2265.
Flaps can come up. Autopilot on.
United 2265,
actually,
17,000.
Yaw damper. Flight director. Autopilot.
Lufthansa 481 radar contact 110 miles northwest of Lincoln, flight level 370. Hello.
And heading. There we go. Indicated airspeed. Let's turn it down. Come on, autopilot. Why is my autopilot not turning on?
Number one, hotel Tango departure at a contact say altitude.
Currently 2,500, climbing 4,000. November 1, hotel Tango.
Number one, hotel Tango, roger. Call maintain flight level 290, you clear direct falls.
290, direct falls. November 1, hotel Tango.
We have center Delta 20 heavy. Did you give us the ILS for 3-1
right.
Visual?
Delta 208, just fly the runway 30 left transition and approach.
We're going to continue our climb. MFD.
Roger,
direct
fly,
2.
Fly 30 left transition. Delta
activate direct to falls.
Twist 714. Descend.
And we're
going to
go nav.
11,000. The Des Moines altimeter is 3014.
And continue our climb. Up to 290.
Cobra 36, contact Des Moines approach on 123.9er.
Autopilot. See, this damn thing gave me this same problem last time. I don't know what's... Somebody tell me how to work an autopilot on a goddamn TBM.
November 5, Mike Whiskey, amend out to maintain flight level 25025. That's going to be the final.
Come on, let's get a little bit more climb out of this thing. Ooh, let's bring that
Walker
power back.
1588, leaving the
we are way too high
Winnipeg
power.
Winnipeg Center is closed. Radar service is terminated. Change to advisories approved.
Bring that power back just a little more.
Delta 246.
There's 290.
Chicago Center on 125.77. Take care.
All right, we're pretty trimmed out. Let me come up here. Fuel select on. Oh, I'm on the wrong one. I was looking at the wrong switch.
Delta
there we go.
246.
God damn.
Chicago
God
Center
damn.
125.
Oh.
Sorry about that. Couldn't tell if you were calling me or somebody else. Chicago Center.
What were you looking for with my... So the fuel selector's down there.
Not a problem.
Yeah, I know. I was looking at this switch thinking that that was my autopilot. That's the autopilot. I am so stupid. I am sorry. There we go. So we are on our way to Falls. Now let's start looking at the Maddie... Let's start looking at that Maddie arrival. Charts. Arrival, Maddie 7. So it looks like we're going Falls, then it's going to be Falls Cole at 210 to 190. Then we got Gurren, Cheddar at 14, Zandi, Hunka, Maddie, Sulu, Kirk, Vulcan, Himgo. Let me just scroll out. Oop. Power setting. Nope, power setting's fine. Let's scroll out just a little bit. God damn it. How do I scroll out on this thing?
FedEx 1251 leaving the airspace to the south. Kansas City
PFD.
Center is closed. Radar services terminated. Change to advisories approved. Take care.
PFD map settings? Is that what it is? HSI traffic settings. No, back. Who knows how to change the goddamn thing? I love the mock oral check ride in a week. Thanks for the free prep. Well, I'm happy. I'm happy to help. That's kind of the whole point. Is to help y'all make sure that you are ready to pass your check rides. Because it sucks. Let's just be honest. It really does suck failing a goddamn check ride. I have only ever failed a stage check, and I fucking hated it. It felt like shit. So I love helping other people. Make sure that they are prepped and ready. All right, we're above 10. Let's go ahead and transition to a better climb speed. Let's go ahead and put this up at... Ooh, wait a minute. We're in a TBM. Let's set 200.
Jungle 5-7, descend at pilot's discretion.
There it is.
1-1-E-11.
We are continuing our climb on the way up. So, now that we got this shit all set up, I figured it out. It's this knob down here that scrolls that. So, here's how we select our different little things. Does this work as a joystick, too? No, it doesn't. All right. I have figured out the TBM. It's a lot. The TBM is... a lot. Given that I've never flown one ever in my entire ever life, I feel like I'm doing pretty good. You look into Pilot Edge yet? Yes, I did look into Pilot Edge. I did send them an email. The problem is they're only on the West Coast. They're only on the fucking West Coast, and I'm currently in NeoFly, flying out here on the East Coast. So once I start pecking my way across in NeoFly, if I get a base or something out there, so let's look. I do have a base, right? So here in NeoFly, if I come down here, I did finally start my airline, right? I've got a customer satisfaction rate of 33%. Oh, come on. I think I'm doing better than Mesa Airlines. I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
431 Bravo Whiskey, contact Des Moines approach 123.9.
Yeah, I can definitely tell, Mouth, over on YouTube, that the TBM is definitely an enjoyable plane to fly, but it's definitely a lot on your first little bit of flying, right? So we do have an airline, right, that we are working on. But our airline is currently based out of Green Bay, right? As you can see right up there in the top left, we are currently based out of Green Bay. We'll start pecking our way across. The bases out on the East Coast, they're kind of expensive, right? So let's just look at this one real quick. This one is $35,000 a week to rent it. All right, and there's only two runways on it. There's not even an ILS there. I start looking at some of the fancier ones. Where's like LAX? All right, if I look out at like if I hub myself at LAX, that is $55,000 a week to move out there. Like, that's just that is just rough. That is just rough. Look, I only have $333,000. Like, I ain't got the money to fly to move my entire operation way the hell out there. So you know, let's do a few more missions here.
Tango, contact Chicago Center on 120.35. Get in.
120.35. Cheese one. Sorry, November 1 Hotel Tango. Chicago Center, this is November 1 Hotel Tango, 15,000.
November 1 Hotel Tango, Chicago Center, call and maintain flightable 290.
290, November 1 Hotel Tango. Check F70 for a base? All right, sure, let's see what F70 costs. All right, F70, so there's no ILS. I don't really like that, but it is only $25,000 a week. So I mean, that's a little more affordable. That's a little more affordable. So we might be looking at that. Oh, awesome. Awesome. Thanks for catching that, Mouth, over on YouTube. We are on with Chicago Center now. The handoff was pretty nice. How is everybody doing? It has an RNAV? Okay, maybe an RNAV. What's up, Ahmed? The problem with only an RNAV is once I start getting into the airliners, a lot of airliners, like, they can't do LPVs. Like, the smaller airliners can't do LPVs. Yes, I am on Instagram as well, and on Twitch. So we are Twitch, Instagram, and YouTube. Yeah. If you head on over to Twitch, I get ad revenue over there, so it really helps out the channel. So if you, you know, if you want to do that, you know, it's
maintain 2,700 till established, cleared for the ILS 26 left, goes 224.
All right, that doesn't do anything. That's good. Yeah. Oh well, I appreciate you heading on over. KSNA, what's KSNA? Let's see how much KSNA is. But then you also got to remember, like, I gotta move all my planes and shit out there too. That's $40,000 a week. That's $40,000 a week, and that's what I pay in Green Bay. So, I'll see if we can find some way to get out that direction, and then go from there.
Contact Chicago Center 125.57.
Mouth 1060 following over on Twitch. Thank you so much for that. As you can tell, there's a little bit more going on over here on Twitch. you know, I know everyone's like, no, this is not AI radio comms. This is a person. There is a person over there. Sorry, I keep peeping at my, I got a 3D print going on back there. It's a new headphone rack. All right. What's up, Alpha? We're on Twitch. I'm thirsty. I need to go get some goddamn water, but we can't leave our goddamn seat.
224, runway 26 left, clear to land. 26 left, clear to land, Scout 224.
So, anybody got any other questions? Anything else, you know? As always, I am always more than happy to help out. You know, anybody who's got any questions about aviation? I know there's a couple people talking about approach. What does it say? Can you explain what is an approach ban? I'm not sure what an approach ban is. But speaking of approaches, let's go ahead and take a look at our approach plate. Well, actually, let's get some weather in Chicago. So that's Green Bay. Actually, I think I could just do... info.
Spirit Wings 7. 79 cross fire at denied or south to the O'Hare altimeter, 2 ladder correction 3008.
What is the ATIS in Chicago? What is the ATIS in Chicago? Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. That's not what I want to do. Oh, for fuck's sakes. I'm just going to look it up over here. All right. ATIS in Chicago is one. What was it? Where'd it go? Shit. It is 135.40. Let's put that in nav in COM2, actually. Cancel. 134? Where'd it go? ATIS, Chicago, 134 or 135.4. All right, MFD.
Fairwing 779.
NAVCOM, there we go.
2-8 from November 5-9. 9,750 available.
Notice the crew air mission.
Runway 4 left. 2 squared closed. Runway 2
do you have any? No, so I currently don't have any videos, but I, you know what? I'll make one. I will make one. So, information Victor.
O'Hare International Airport, ATIS information Victor 2351 Zulu. West 250 at 11. Visibility 10, 4,600 meters. Temperature 4, 2. Minus 6. Altimeter 3008. Arrivals expect ILS approach runway 27 center. ILS approach runway 28 center. Simultaneous approach is in use. Breeze may call runway hold short instruction. Departures expect runway 22 left. 2-8 from November 5-9. 9,750 available. Notices to air mission.
All right.
Runway 4 left.
We've got our ATIS. So we're expecting runway 27 center. That's the runway we're going to aim for. So let's go back to our... I don't even know what the fuck to call this. Procedure.
And center Skyways 224, clear.
Approach. Let's go with...
Skyways 224, taxi to the ramp. Have a good night.
Let's go with...
Have a good night. Thanks.
I gotta go
service.
Find the ILS runway 27. Center. ILS runway 27 center. There it is. We're gonna expect vectors.
November 4, Sierra Tango.
We're gonna load it.
Radar service terminated. Frequency change approved.
Over to Unicom. Thanks for the control. We'll see you at 4, Sierra Tango.
There we go. Let's go back over to this page. Well, we'll go back to MFD. Home. Map. There we go. I like it. Yeah, VATSIM isn't easy to set up. Like, let's just be honest. VATSIM is not an easy task to set up. It took me a while to figure it all out. And so VATSIM is technically like, it's VATSIM, it's SimBrief, it's VPilot, and VATSPY all working together to make this happen. So it's not a simple process. So the video, when I do end up making one, It's probably gonna be like an hour long, going over all the different like how to set this shit up. So if you go to vatsim.com, I think that's what it is, vatsim.com. It's gonna give you a little bit. You gotta sign up for an account, all right? So go sign up for an account on VATSIM, on SimBrief, VATSIM, SimBrief, and. Where else do you need to sign up for an account? Navigraph is another one. Navigraph isn't free. So just keep that in mind. Navigraph isn't free. I use Navigraph, and that's how I get my charts in game. We're working to try and get ourselves an Airbus. That is like the end goal, is an Airbus. We're currently in a TBM 930, which is, don't get me wrong, it's a nice little plane. It's a nice little plane. It's a whole lot better than what we started out in. We started out this in a Cessna 152. We started out with a Cessna 152 and a Cessna Skycatcher with my coworker. Now, if I come over here, I can show you all my coworker. We call him Bo. His name's Berlin, but we call him Bo. See, there he is. He's currently at KPHN. He's in flight right now at cruise. He's in a GA30. He's in a G36 Bonanza. So it's kind of a nice plane. There he is right there in cruise. He's going back to Green Bay right now. So he's got a little bit more to go. He's going to be crossing the pond. Hopefully he's climbing up to an appropriate altitude to cross the pond. Here's all my finances, showing how much monies I got. This is the logbook. So as you can see, we started out in our little Cessna 152, and we worked our way up. We are now in our TBM. Here's all the aircraft, right? So let's see what's available for sale in Chicago. So 787, 747, 320. Another 320. Beechcraft. Cessna Longitude, right? There's all kinds of fancy fucking airplanes here. And right over here, this is where we're managing our flight from. This is where we're at. We're bringing one passenger to O'Hare. So where am I flying right now? I am currently near Milwaukee. So if I just take a look at the map real quick. I'm not even nearly near Milwaukee. I'm still way up here. So I still got a ways to go. Zandy is our next fix. We just crossed Cheddar. So let's head back inside. I want to see where we are. So they're still leaving me way high. They're probably leaving me way high because it's not like I'm fast. Oh, they're leaving me way high because I never even finished my climb. And Chicago Center. This is November 1 Hotel Tango. Wondering if you want me to descend via the Maddie. Oh, please tell me these people didn't get off plane.
Give me just a second.
Oh, no, he's still there. Because I just crossed Cheddar, and Cheddar, if I'm going to be doing the arrival, I should be at Cheddar at 14.
November 1, Hotel Tango, for now, maintain flight level 270. I'll start you down shortly.
Stop my climb, 270, November 1, Hotel Tango. And there we go, leveling out at 270. Yeah, because, like, ain't no reason for us to be climbing way the fuck up there. I guess I should have kept my climb at, like... I shallowed out my climb. I guess I could expedite that climb a little bit. Let me get a little more scoochums. We're down at 95% power. I do understand that we're in a turboprop, and turboprops just don't have that kind of juice. But... Spirit Recurrent on the 3rd. Any tips? Go through your emergencies. Go through your emergencies. Go through your profiles. Go through your emergencies. Go through your profiles. Go through your button trainer again. Make sure you know all your callouts. Then maintain 10,000 and 3004 on the altimeter for November 1 Hotel Tango.
And Chicago Center United.
And they're sending me all the way down to 10,000 now.
31 for 30 on the wind 5 arrival.
United 22 arrived at Chicago Center, squawk 1662.
Oh, this is such a... 2290. I guess I could start my vertical speed. I can start my descent. And then continue my scrolling down. You know, most people stress about the oral portion more on a recurrent than they do the flight. Because, I mean, they've been flying it this entire time. But, like, they let's be honest. When was the last time you opened up your books, right? You probably ain't opened up your books in ages. So it's completely normal for you to be stressed out about the oral portion of your mock checker or of your recurrent. But you're probably going to do fine. Right? Remember, you've been doing this the entire time. Just make sure you go brush up on your emergencies, go brush up on your profiles, your callouts, your memory items, right? All of that stuff that you don't do regularly.
November 1 Hotel Tango to set maintain 8,000.
Down to 8,000, November 1 Hotel Tango. There's 8. The big cheese in the TBM. Yes, I am. I'm in a TBM. We're doing 1,700 feet per minute down, descending down into Chicago, down to 8,000. You know what? What I'm going to do, actually, is I'm going to do this in indicated airspeed mode. Shit, I set my altitude too high. There's 8,000. Let's crank up our indicated airspeed up to 250. Because that's our max speed below 10,000. So let's descend at 250. I don't think our passengers are too worried about it, right? Holy shit, 6,000 feet per minute. Maybe that was a little excessive. God damn, 8,000 feet per minute. Okay, maybe this was a mistake. All right, now that we're getting up on our speed, it's starting to shallow out, right? We're not just gonna rock 9,000 feet per minute down to 8,000, right? Come on, start picking that nose up. Pick that nose up. Okay, that's much better. That is much better. All right, through 18, let's set our altimeter setting of 3004. Set our altimeter setting up here of 3004.
American 635, short vector, figure ascent, flying 270. 270,
American 635. I can increase the rate of descent.
I really wish he would give me like a expect a runway, because a runway would be nice, right? I planned for 27 center, but I don't know. Given that I'm a TBM, he might be giving the center runways to like airliners and shit. But this thing's not too hard to fix. Look at that thing. Look at that beautiful ass TBM. But how is everybody doing? Trying to think of what I did today. So I made some videos, right? Yeah, that's really all I did today. I think I took the cat for a walk. Yeah, I took the cat outside. I took some trash out. I started a 3D print. Is it almost done? Yeah, it's almost done. How much longer on that print? Let's see. Looks like it's an hour left on that print, so we should be getting that print should be done right around the same time that we're landing in Chicago. This is kind of a journey, but we are making like 20 grand off of it, so that's not too bad. I just want to make sure my controllers are staying on. Let's see, do we still have a controller at Chicago? Looks like, yes, we do still have three different controllers at Chicago. Awesome.
Southwest 2431 cleared, direct Fisk, descend and maintain 11,000.
Oh, let's look at our, I kind of want to look at my taxi diagram in Chicago.
Confirming 779, contact Chicago approach, 11.0.
All right, home, charts, info, taxi diagram, there we go. Huh.
Southwest 2491, cleared, direct Fisk, descend and maintain 11,000.
Oh shit, you can get a touchpad? That's awesome. That's awesome. Alright, so if we land on 27 center, it's gonna be. That's cargo. Where's the executive ramps? I always forget where the damn executive ramps are. That's the cargo ramp. Oh, general aviation. So it's actually going to be a right turn off, and the general aviation ramp is right there. Okay. Y'all see that, right? Y'all see that?
Confirming 779, contact Chicago approach, 11.0. 19-0, confirming 779, for the help.
All right, moving along. You know what? This is just really what people do in cruise, right?
2557 out of level 2.
I know, you know, when I was an airline, or, you know, when I was actively flying, you know, regularly.
Contact Chicago approach, 119.2.
119.2, November 1 Hotel Tango. Chicago Center. This is November 1 Hotel Tango, 11 descending 8. Was it 119.2? Is that what he said? Chicago said, oh, he might have said zero. That's it. There he is.
Chicago Piper 7612 Julia on the ground at Waukee, and if we can pick up our IFR to Brenton Harbor.
7612 Juliet. Clear sound request, standby.
Chicago Center, November 1 Hotel Tango, 10 descending 8.
1 Hotel Tango, Chicago approach. Hello. Expect ILS 27 Center approach.
Expect ILS 27 Center, November 1 Hotel Tango. I keep almost calling myself Cheese 1 because that's what my call sign normally is, but I guess they just didn't want to accept Cheese 1 this time. So rude. So rude. All right, let's see.
United 1168, runway 28 center, clear to land. One 145 Alpha Juliet, turn right heading 250, join the 27 center localizer.
250 to turn the localizer to 27 center, follow Juliet.
Stereo wing 779, descend, maintain 6,000.
6,000.
All right, zoom in a little bit so that we can see where we're going.
Qatar 26 Bravo Heavy, contact Chicago Center 120.35.
So we're about to hit Maddie at 8. Then it's going to be crossing Sulu.
1235,
Qatar 26 Bravo Heavy,
thank you.
Chicago approach, American 635,
112,000.
All right, not a big deal.
Yeah, American 635, Chicago approach. Expect ILS 28 center approach.
Looks like he's probably going to cut me off from Kirk.
American 635, one, advise when you are able, direct Linda.
Roger, direct Linda, American 635,
I can do
now.
Not yet, just program your FMC for Linda.
Roger,
oh, I see what he's going to do. Never mind. So it looks like what's probably going to happen is
would you prefer, sir?
We're going to continue on and then a right turn off of him go.
Roger, we're filed in for 27 center, so we can take that. Does that work?
November 7, Spirit Wing 779, sure, expect ILS 27 center approach.
All right. Awesome.
November
1, awesome.
Off of Juliet. Join the localizer and then advise when you have the airport in sight.
That's the airport in sight, and we're going to localize the file for Juliet.
Okay, 145 off of Juliet, clear visual approach 27 center.
Clear for visual approach 27 center, off of Juliet.
Normally there's like a bunch of people out here flying around with me. Don't nobody want to come hang out?
Last day of aircraft calling, standby.
Let's see. So we know where we're going, we know where we're parking, we know what approach we're doing. I think we're going to be good.
United 1933, turn right heading 360, runway.
I'm happy with this.
Right,
I'm happy with where we're going. I'm happy with our plans going. I'm happy that our plans
sir,
moving on.
Landing 360, United 1933.
Oh, God. Sorry. I have to take my goddamn braces out.
Right,
I am dying.
240.
The weather is kind of boring, though. Yeah, I feel like I should throw
American
some... What kind of weather should we throw in?
9,000
Linda. 9,000 Linda, American 635.
Departure, good evening. United 658, holding short November 5, to leave right. Ready to go.
United.
What kind of weather should we put in? Should we put ILS minimums? Right? I think we should put ILS minimums. I think we're definitely going to put ILS minimums in. Let's see. Fuck live weather. Oh, that fucked with me a lot. Let's set our altimeter setting though. 300.
November 7612 Juliet. I have a clearance advisory to copy.
We're ready.
300.
Juliet cleared to the Michigan Regional Airport via direct.
0.4.
Expect 7,000 minutes after departure with 0063.
Point. There we go. There we go. There we go. That's much better. That thing was all over the. That our altimeter was all over the place. Let's go.
7612 Juliet.
7612 Juliet. Read back correct. Advise ready for taxi.
Welcome.
November 1 for my number 27.
There we go. And we're going to set those.
Do not exceed 210 knots. Join the localizer.
Roger, slow and below 210. Localizer 27.
American 6.
There we go.
15 miles from Linda, across Linda, 9000, cleared ILS to a center.
Altitude bottom. We're going to set that at like 400.
United at 658. Standby. I got to wait for the guy to turn first.
You know what? We'll set it 600 just to be safe. Well, what's our... Yeah, no, that's fine.
Delta 1701, Chicago approach, ILS 2A center approach. Information, whiskey of current, the O'Hare altimeter 3008.
Now, is it not going to let me adjust to give, like, storms and shit? Oh, come on. Let me add some storms in here.
22 left, clear for takeoff.
Great, 22 left.
All right.
United 658, fly runway heading runway 28 right at November 5, clear for takeoff. Runway
looks like my landing lights are on right when they shouldn't be. I don't know why my landing lights are on.
Tango, turn left heading 090.
Left turn 09. Left turn 090, November 1 Hotel Tango. All right, left turn 090. All right, heading mode.
Awesome. 1625 ILS 28 center approach.
What you call it? I was on VATSIM 20 years ago. Online flight planning never worked. I mean, it works now. All right, so he gave me a heading of 090. So he's just sending me outbound so that I can come back inbound. All right, not a big deal. 8,000 seems a little high, though. 8,000 is a bit high. So let's see where that goes.
779 actually does not maintain 5,000 till established. 5,000 till established, cleared ILS 2700 approach.
For 5,000 till we got it,
2700. I go online first and let the app do it, or ATC, I can't remember. Yeah, you let the app do it for now. But since there's so many, since there's so many more people like doing these things now, there's a lot more like default flight plans, right? This thing works now. It's just a matter of like a lot of times the controllers will just like randomly get off, and then like you're just sitting there in the dark. What you call it? I don't know about messing with config files for flight plans. Oh, yeah, no. That doesn't work. Army had rolling. Yeah, no, the throwing the flight plan in the config file isn't really, you know, something that I do. That's kind of a pain in the ass. You can do like SimBrief Downloader, and SimBrief Downloader will do it for you. Down to 4,000, one Hotel Tango.
Southwest 3466, good evening, Chicago approach. Is there any way we can get our PDC?
3466, sorry, let me just get that for you real quick.
No, Roger, no, you're busy tonight, thank you.
There we go, down to 4,000. Indicated airspeed. Scroll up our indicated airspeed to 250. There we go. All right, so now what we need to do, we need to go procedure, activate vectors to final, because that's what we're doing right now. Yep, still in heading mode. No nav got armed. We're fine. What's up, Levantar? What's up, Levantar? We are doing VATSIM. We are doing, we are flying from Green Bay to Chicago in a TBM 930. That's what's going on. Thanks for showing up, man. Thanks for showing up. This is what we're flying. It's a beautiful fucking airplane. I keep trying to turn up the wear and tear so that it doesn't look so goddamn beautiful, but it just doesn't seem to be working. I don't know why. All right.
145 Alpha Julia, signature ramp taxi at Delta. I think that's Tango Tango.
There we go. But does anybody have any requests? Anybody got any requests after we do this? Because we're going to Chicago right now. So has anybody got any requests?
15 Alpha Tango. Yeah, it is Tango Tango. 15 Alpha Juliet, signature ramp via Echo Tango Tango. Hold short 27 center.
Landing on 27 center. So if we once we land on 27 center, it should just be a right turn, and general aviation ramp is right up there. What's up, Demon Diver? Thank you so much for the follow, Demon Diver.
Arnett Yankee 22 left approach 17,600.
How's your night going? Do all those basement nerds know they're in the presence of a real pilot? Oh, come on. Like, don't be mean, right? There ain't no point in ever being mean to anybody. Being mean is always pointless. Everybody's just out here trying to have a good time. Everyone's trying to practice. Everyone's trying to enjoy themselves. Just because I went through all the training and everything doesn't mean I can't have any more fun than they can. Thanks for all the PPL videos, dude.
Turn right heading 180, maintain 210 knots.
Right turn 180, maintain 210. One Hotel Tango.
Lindbergh
1625,
descend maintains 7,000.
All right, come on. And then we got to slow down. Let's just go ahead, scroll back to indicated, and 210. Oh, shut up.
November 145 off Juliet, cross runway 27 center, Tango Tango into the signature ramp. Traffic's on a 5 mile final, no delay.
There we go. Good. All right, we're about to land. We're about to land. All right. Now what's going on? Hi, I'm playing VATSIM. Seems like it could be a real good tool. Yes, it can be a real good tool. My wife is the real pilot. Oh, come on. I'm a real pilot too, Necromancer. I have done this approach a fucking countless times in the CRJ-200. So this is like nothing. Maintain 210. There we go. Ooh, that was a little too much. God damn, the TBM responds a whole lot slower than the CRJ-200.
Was that Southwest 3279? Yes, it was.
There we go. That should maintain 210.
792 due left. Text me at Tango Yankee. November 1, Hotel Tango, turn right heading 250, join the localizer.
Right 250 for the localizer, 1 Hotel Tango. So an ATD is an aviation training device, meaning that it's actually been approved by the FAA.
Turn left heading 120.
Yeah, an ATD, it's technically you can log time in an ATD. It's a sim that's been approved by the FAA as an aviation training device. Yeah, you can log like 2.5 hours, and I think you can log like 10 of them for instrument.
Number 1, Hotel Tango, while you're on the localizer, report O'Hare, report in sight.
IFR, you mind if I just do the full ILS, 1 Hotel Tango?
November 1, Hotel Tango, 6 miles from Jimbo, maintain 4,000 till established, cleared ILS, 27 center approach.
Cleared ILS, 27 center approach, appreciate it, 1 Hotel Tango. Alright, approach mode's armed. So that's the thing. You can log it. Log it. There ain't no reason why not to. Just make sure that there's an instructor associated with it, right? Don't log ATD if there's not an instructor associated with it or you're not an instructor. Okay? Alright, yeah, we are good to go. We are about to land, right? ATD is a great training tool. Use it, right? If it's with your old CFI and you can't get a hold of them anymore, you can't fill out, and they can't sign it, they can't fill out your logbook, I guess sucks to suck. Make sure you log all your time, right? All your time. Log all of it.
You're not 1168. Sorry about the wait. Cross 28 right at Echo Echo.
All right, we've been cleared for our approach. Not cleared to land yet.
Southwest 2491, 20 miles from TAC. Cross TAC at 3,000, cleared.
Just a smidge more power. Good. Good shit. Good shit. I think it's signed. I haven't looked because it's in the first page of my book. Oh, well, yeah. I mean, if it's the first page of your book, I know it could be a little difficult. But, I mean, if it was signed, you know, log it. There ain't no goddamn point in not logging, you know, ATD. ATD is, again...
Number one, Hotel Tango, 27 Center, clear to land.
27 Center, clear to land. Lake one, or correction, November 1, Hotel Tango. All right. We are cleared to land.
779, welcome to Chicago. Left one able. Safe parking.
Left one able, going to Lima 5, Fairwing 779.
Fairwing 779, taxi to the Lima terminal via...
All right.
Echo, actually...
So we're still going to Driscoll, and Driscoll's our final approach fix, so we're still good. I'm already at 50 hours, so it's not like I'll be struggling for hours. Okay. Well, later on, right? Time is time. Take it. Take the time, right? Now that, you know, I'm not, like, actively flying, I'd give anything for fucking flight time. You know, I'm not current anymore. I've lost all currency. I've lost all recency. Yeah. Well, okay. I lied. Technically, I've been doing stuff in the full motion sim. So I guess technically I'm still current. All right. So we're almost to Driscoll. 2.5 from Driscoll. 250. You think? Traffic. I'm going to reduce some power. I know. Gear down. Three takeoffs and landings before passengers, but don't... There's instrument currency. There's specific aircraft currency.
All right.
Runway in sight. Landing. Gear down. Slowing down for flaps.
Limburg 1625, descend and maintain 4,000. That would just be the 210. 4, then 210. Delta 1701, descend and maintain 4,000. That would just be the 210.
120. Maintain 4,000.
All right, still slowing down. I see the runway.
7612 Juliet, taken.
That's the appropriate runway. We are all good.
We're heading 120. 7612 Juliet, radar contact. And you're good. Climb and maintain 7,000.
One notch of flaps.
They were up to 7,600.
Another notch of flaps.
American 635, turn
right. All right, flaps are set.
Right on top of Golf Golf.
Autopilot off. The TBM has such a slow approach speed. Holy shit. Oh my god. That's the traffic.
November 7612 Juliet, clear direct destination.
Direct destination, 7612 Juliet.
Why is there a fucking airliner descending over top of me? And Chicago approach, this is November 1 Hotel Tango. Just want to verify. Clear to land, 27 Center.
1 Hotel Tango, affirmative runway 27 Center, clear to land, wind 26 are at 10.
And approach United 2290 is 5 miles out of fire at 9,000.
Number 1625, turn left.
And just make sure we've got the appropriate. Yeah, that's 27 Center. All right, well, I guess that's just people fucking around.
United,
I'm all fucked up.
Chicago approach turn left heading 200 vectors ILS 28 center. Descend and maintain 7,000.
7,000 and turn left heading 200, you said?
Okay, firm. So this 3279 clear direct.
There we go.
Contact, clear direct to Lukey. Climb and maintain 15,000. Stay altitude leaving.
Direct Lukey up to 15,000.
Let me get on my. Well, no, I got a yaw damper. I shouldn't need rudders. I see the GA parking.
United 2290, descend and maintain 8,000, left turn heading 200. You got that, maintain.
There's the inner marker.
250 knots, left turn 208,000 United 2290.
Just a little high on that flare.
Chicago approach American 313. What runway can we expect for the O'Hare 8 departure?
American 313, you can expect 22 left.
22 left, thank
you. All right.
American 313, we're unable to...
Let's go find our parking. Yeah, that wasn't the best. That wasn't the best landing.
Turned.
American 313, is there any reason you're unable to O'Hare 8 departure?
313, we are air wreck.
Delta 1701,
oh, shit.
Heading 360.
That's a 360, Delta 1701.
Number 1625, clear dial.
Oh, that's a runway. This is Microsoft Flight Sim. Oh, well, shit. Thank you so much.
313, the O'Hare 8 departure, it's not going to be in the FMC. You can just expect radar vectors. And then the PDC says climb by a SID. So check the chart. There's an altitude restriction that you have to cross certain distance from O'Hare, and then you're going to maintain 5,000.
All right. Let's see where the fuck we're parking.
Thank you, American 313.
Delta 1701, turn left heading 300, join the 28 center, localizer.
I left at 330, doing the ILS for...
Where the fuck are we? Almost...
300.
300, but...
I've never directly witnessed a pilot deviation. I had a student get a pilot deviation on a check ride one time, and that was kind of funny.
Trying to maintain 4,000.
10 degrees right down to 4,000.
Come on, don't freeze. Don't freeze.
Delta 1704 on 4,000 until established. Cleared ILS 28 center.
Trying to figure out exactly where I'm at here, because I feel like I should have had a right turn by now.
Maintain 4,000 until on the 28 center. I was expecting 27 center.
Oh, you're expecting 27 center? That's fine. Okay. You can descend and maintain 3,000 until established. Cleared ILS 27 center approach.
So the student that got the pilot deviation on their check ride, they almost busted the Bravo. They violated an altitude constraint that got them closer to the Bravo than they were supposed to be.
Alpha to the terminal.
Roger, cross 28 right at Golf, and then Lima, November, Alpha.
You flipped in November, Lima, Lima, Alpha.
That was commercial check ride, actually.
Lima, Lima, Alpha, American 65.
There we go.
November 1, Hotel Tango to Signature via Delta. Tango, Tango, cross runway 22 right on Delta.
Delta, Tango, Tango, cross runway 28 right on Delta. November 1, Hotel Tango.
It's going to be 22 right on Delta.
22 right, sorry about that.
No worries, United 2290, turn 10 degrees right.
10 degrees to the right, United 2290.
And United 2290, looks like you turned 10 degrees left last time, so turn 30 degrees right.
30 degrees to the right, United 2290.
Somebody's over here turning the wrong direction. This also doesn't look appropriate. Where the fuck am I?
Delta 1701, runway 27 center.
I hate how Navigraph just tries to, like, pull up so much shit at one time. Like, I just want a taxi diagram. All right. Chicago. Open charts. Taxi. Why am I not on the plate? Yeah, I'm not on the fucking plate. That didn't help at all. I'm trying to fucking read a goddamn taxiway sign. I can't read a fucking taxiway sign. No, that student didn't fail that check. I actually argued with the DPE for a while, saying that he should have, but they didn't fucking fail him. I don't really understand how. Open airport. Charts. Yeah, no, I'm not. That landing wasn't that great. Like, I'm just going to be honest. That landing was not that great.
Descending 13-7 with whiskey.
921-15 Chicago approach, ident.
All right, let's zoom in.
Number 1625, right turn, Papa, hold short of golf, golf.
Okay, so I am on Delta right now.
240 on the localizer, at turn 290.
There we go. All right, I'm good. I'm good. I know where I'm at.
Descend to maintain at 900,250 off the O'Hare altimeter.
You know, I just expected to see like a taxiway sign or literally anything by now.
Airway to the altimeter, United 2115.
United 2115, turn left heading 280 for the ILS 28 center.
But no, that student that got the pilot deviation,
United 2115.
They did not fail their check ride. Somehow, fucking somehow, they got a pilot deviation on their commercial check. And the examiner's excuse was, well, I didn't catch it either until it happened. So if I didn't catch it, I can't really fault them. And I'm like, well, you can, though. Like, you can fail somebody on a check ride for something that you didn't notice, even if it ends up being like a violation, you know, a safety violation or a regulation violation. I mean, they didn't technically bust the Bravo. All right, yep, here's Delta crossing runway 22. I mean, they didn't technically bust the Bravo. They just busted their altitude limitation, which provided separation from the Bravo. And so it wasn't a DPE. It was an examiner from UND. So
Hazel 4000 cleared the ILS 28 center approach.
All right. So let's try and see where we're at. I'm trying to find Tango Tango. So I am on Delta right now. Tango Tango is the next one. Okay. So yeah, it wasn't a DPE. It was actually an examiner from UND. And I really didn't agree with it. I even told the student, I was like, hey, like, that is entirely unacceptable, and that shouldn't be your expectation for check rides at all, ever in the future. It was concerning. It was concerning, to say the least. Let's see. Once we park, let's actually see what our feet per minute was on that landing.
Number 1625, that's fine. I won't take you all the way down to golf course. You can cross 28 right on Papa 3, or yeah, Papa 4 there. And then right turn November, Alpha 15, Alpha to parking.
Right turn November, Alpha 15, parking.
Is this Tango Tango? Yeah, this looks like Tango Tango.
290, runway 28 center, clear to land, wind 260 at 10.
Clear to land.
Yeah, there's signature over there. Let's go park over there.
Delta 1701, cross runway 22 right on Echo, hold short runway 27 left on Tango Tango.
So here's the thing. If you were like an airline pilot with your own airplane and you wanted to fly to work, this is technically where you would go. Atlanta, believe it or not, actually has parking for for their pilots if they have their own airplanes. It's kind of funny. All right, I'm happy with this parking spot. When it comes to oral on private pilot exams, have you noticed a commonality? Yes, a lot of students struggle with specifics from their POH.
And Southwest 3466, Chicago approach. Hello, we are requesting pushback.
Oh, let's leave the beacon on.
3466, Chicago departure.
All that can shut down. Awesome. I am now a second officer. That is awesome. Look at that. Oh, you guys can't see it, can you? Because it's coming up from a different... Well, let's open up NeoFly, and y'all might be able to see it. Oh, nope. Y'all still can't see it. Either way, I am now a second officer. Wow, I actually got a lot of experience for that. Holy shit. Total flight reward experience was... 234. Holy shit. Bonus security granted, 19% aircraft. Awesome. Awesome. Now let's see what we can do now. Okay, so I am a second officer. I believe this means that I can hire another pilot. So there's Ghost Rider. Who should we get? Should we get Ghost Rider or Maverick? Ghost Rider or Maverick? Who are we thinking? Ghost Rider or Maverick? Yeah, students struggle with specifics from their POH. They also struggle with specifics from the regs. Like they've never read the book. That's really where students struggle the most, is they've never actually read the fucking book. This is a mode on Microsoft Flight Sim. No, it's a mod for Microsoft Flight Sim. So this is NeoFly. If you go check out NeoFly, make sure you let them know CheesePilot sent you. But this is NeoFly, and what this does is it adds a... You can make your own fucking airline out of Microsoft Flight Sim. So who are we getting, Maverick or Ghost Rider? Oh, Xbox. That's rough. I'm sorry. All right, we're getting Maverick. We're going to hire this pilot. Oh, wait a minute. How many pilots can I hire? Can I just hire both of them? Ooh, can we hire Iceman? I want to hire Iceman. Oh, max I can hire is 2. Damn. Well, shit. Well, wait a minute. Once Berlin lands, I'm sorry, Berlin. You've been with me for a while. I'm sorry, Bo, but like, you done, Bo. Like you done. Let's see. Efficiency better for longer flights. Dexterity. All right. Let's get you a damn plane. Where are you at? You're at KUNU. Let's find you a plane at KUNU. What do we got here? We got you a 152. We got a Comanche. Ooh, we can fucking just straight up. Oh, no, we can't just straight up buy that Comanche. We can get you a Murdy Cap, whatever that is. The Pilatus. We can get him a Pilatus. We can rent it. Yeah, we could rent that Pilatus. Or we could buy him a Cessna 152. What are we thinking? What about that business jet? Oh, I don't think I could afford that King Air. Yeah, no, I can't afford the King Air. The King Air's got a $770,000 deposit. Oh, son of a bitch! God damn it!
Damn, son, where'd you park?
Fucking A, Steve. All right. So no, we're not gonna give him Berlin's plane. I think we'll get him this Comanche. I think we'll definitely get him this. Well, no. Look. Steve would have his own house if he didn't. If he'd stop spending money being annoying. Oh, son of a bitch, Steve. I'm fucking good. What can he fly? So as a... Oh, but he's a cadet. I'm sorry, but... yeah, no, you're gone. The fuck is that? All right. Iceman. So Iceman is a second officer. Is there any captains I can hire? No. So I guess we're going to hire Iceman. What is it? Whiskey India 89. There ain't shit. Oh, there's another TBM. Oh, but I can't buy it. There's a beaver. There's a cub. What about Green Bay? We'll send him back to Green Bay, see if there's anything good there. There's an icon. There's a caravan. Can I afford the deposit on the caravan? I can afford the deposit on the caravan. Looks like... Yeah. We're renting out a caravan. And let's go to the hangar. There's no pilot there, so we need to come down to our staff. We need to move Iceman to the caravan. Ooh, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of money. Oh. All right. So, let's put Iceman in the caravan. And see what we can do with the caravan. All right, so there's that. All right, that's not bad. Ooh, but we can do better. Oh, no, we can't do better. And I need you. And I miss you. And now I wonder. I'm sorry. All right. We're doing that one. And send him. Awesome. Even though that's technically a tour plane, it's still awesome. All right. Let's go back to our airline. See if we can... See if we can adjust some lines. Oh, no. That's not what I wanted. Hub's already rented. No, that's not what I want. I want to edit my lines. Oh, because I'm still... GRB. Come on. It's giving me shit. There we go. Now, can we do airline stuff? KORD, generate return flight. There we go. Oh, for fuck's sakes. Steve, really? Over here clipping shit? Oh my god. All right, let's go to our job finder. Where's the airline one? That's VIP. That's helicopter. That's tourist. That's secret. What is that? That's military interception, parachutist, fire, search and rescue. That's general aviation. Where the fuck is the airline one? Oh, airline passengers. Oh, minimum rank captain. Oh, well, okay. Let's go back to our, let's go back here and let's delete that.
Let's watch some crazy stuff, yo.
The fuck?
Rick. Jeez, Rick. Oh my God.
What the? There's nothing.
Hey, wait a minute, Rick. I thought this was a commercial. What's going on? I mean, don't worry about it. Let's just see where this goes.
It's not going
anywhere. Oh my God, it's still the commercial.
What the fuck? Oh. The fuck was that? All right. The fuck was that? It's still the commercial. All right. I guess we can do... Can't we do VIP as a second officer? So as a second officer... he's currently on cargo. He's going to be able to chain stuff. Cargo, express, sensitive, hazardous, emergency, illicit, tourists, advertising, parachute, and passengers. Okay, so he can do... All right, so express, do we have... Can we do some express stuff? All right, sensitive... No, timeline. Deadline. There we go. There we go. And he'll be able to do those missions. Awesome. Well, so let me get this straight. The guy with SIC privileges only flying passengers single pilot. Yes, that's exactly what's going on. That is exactly what's going on. Now, I don't think they have any, if I'm just going to be entirely honest, I don't think NeoFly has any pilots on their development team. And I've talked to them a couple times about some of the stuff, and like they don't really seem that interested in hearing me out, right? So does anybody have any other questions? We're just gonna call it a night tonight. I'm to be honest, I'm not tired. My wife's about to be home, and I'm just gonna go hang out with her. So does anybody have any questions, any interest in anything else? You know, any more aviation questions? Make sure you go check out the YouTube channels if you're looking for mock check rides. If you are looking to do a mock check ride, make sure you head to the website Training with Cheese. Son of a bitch. He's like dancing all over my face. All right, Steve. Y'all have a wonderful night. Let's help me on my CFI check ride. Well, head to trainingwithcheese.com and take a look. But for now, let's roll some credits. I'm so sorry, Steve.